Hi guys, it's Laura. Thank you all for watching and welcome back to my channel. Bye, Mr. Bushtail. Whenever I start the camera, he just leaves. He's like, nope, I'm not having any of this. So anyway, where was I before Mr. Bushtail left? I think I said welcome back to my channel and then I lost my train of thought. So today we're gonna be talking about me finding my faith, which is something that is very personal. I actually never thought I would be making a video like that ever. But last year, something really happened in me inside and I embraced my beliefs in God. And that's what I'm going to talk about today. I actually made a poll on Instagram what video I should film next. And only after half a day, it was very clear that this was the most requested video. So here we are, we're gonna be talking about it. And since it's such a personal thing, I would like to say a few things just so that you know where I'm at and where I see anyone else. So just because I believe in something doesn't mean that anyone else has to believe the same. So I don't care if you are an atheist or Buddhist or Muslim or Christian or any other religion or non-religion, as long as your heart is in the right place, you have place in my heart and I respect your beliefs or the lack of, and all I'm asking for is the same respect for myself. And also, I would like to emphasize that this is just my personal journey, and just because I believe in things in a certain way doesn't mean that that's the only correct way. So again, this is just me sharing my personal experience, and that has basically no impact on any of you guys. So yeah, let's start. So when I was a kid, I grew up being an atheist because my parents had a very strong opinion about religion. They did not identify with any religion. Even though my dad was an altar boy, he did not believe in God. And as far as I know, he still doesn't. And my mom actually very vocally rejected any kind of religion. So it was just not part of who I was. My grandmother, father's side, was on the other hand very religious. And that was actually the only exposure I got to someone believing in God and to any kind of religion. Then I started going to school. That was in the 80s, which sounds like ages ago, and actually it was ages ago. And back then I lived in Czechoslovakia, and the current political system did not encourage religion, so it was more frowned upon. And I even remember that at school, if kids would come to school and they would wear a necklace with any religious icon, they would get in trouble and they had to take it off. I feel like things started being a little bit more relaxed around religion over time, and by the time I was going to high school, it was a non-issue. So if someone was wearing a necklace with any religious icon, I feel like no one really cared then. That was the 90s, or like the end of the 80s and beginning of the 90s. And I started being intrigued by anything spiritual. To be honest, I do not remember exactly how I got into all the spiritual stuff, but I vaguely remember it was partially through some of my friends. I also had some gypsy friends I really liked, and they were a lot into tarot and coffee grounds reading, so I started learning that, and it was a lot of fun. I really enjoyed that. And I had a friend who, together with me, had one of the dumbest idea ever. We created our own Ouija board, and it led to lots of dark stuff in future. That's a subject for a whole another video, and I feel like I should save that one for October before Halloween, because it's quite dark and I have another spooky stories. So let's just, you know, wait with that video. But anyway, so I started looking into that, and I bought myself a collection of spells and I started dabbling with them. I also bought myself an encyclopedia of magic, which was basically a work where there were articles about different mystical things, like myths that people believed in, demons, angels, certain religions, and some specific stuff that was connected to the spiritual. Highly interesting. I still have that book. It is actually written more objectively. It does not necessarily state that something would be real or not real. It is more a collection of basically the historical facts about why people, or like what people believed in. So while I was spiritual, I was also very fond of science. So I logically always also questioned all the things that I was into. Does it really work? Is it really real? Is it just in my head? Is it more of a placebo effect? Are certain things just a self-fulfilling prophecy? So I was not really 100% sure of any of that, besides the self-made Ouija board, because that really freaked me out. It's just something that even though I was into, I never took it too seriously. And also, I was so full of anger, especially in my teens. There were so many issues while I was growing up with me and my mom. Certain things happened, again, a subject for a whole another video. It all resulted in me being already as a kid depressed, very self-conscious, not really believing in myself, and in having lots of anger. And that always also kind of reflected in my spiritual beliefs. And I feel like I've been going through a really dark path for a while. I had some self-destructive tendencies, and it was just not a healthy mindset. And it took years of working on myself until I was able to start letting go of the anger and until everything started improving. Now, moving on to the time when I was already a grown-up. So at some point, I decided to move to Austria. I started building here my new home on my own terms. I felt liberated and happy. I was still someone who would not really believe in themselves, and I was going kind of back and forth between being spiritual and not believing in anything at all. And when I'm really 100% honest with myself, and when I look back, I think that I always went back to spiritual when I was not happy, when I really needed something to lift me up, to help my mindset, to help me to move on, to be strong again. And whenever I was happy, I was like, nah, don't care, don't really believe in anything. That being said, I always felt very drawn to spirituality naturally, subconsciously. And whenever I would enter any kind of place that was linked to the spiritual, be it some place in the woods that's sacred or a church or whatnot, I always felt this energy going through me, and I always felt something I could not really identify, but it just felt so right, and it always made me feel so at peace inside, so I could not deny that at some point. My life brought, just like anyone else's life, some ups and downs. There were some pretty close calls, and one time that was so close that I thank God every day that I'm still here. I almost lost my fingers, and I could have also possibly died if that issue were not treated. So, if you're interested in that story, I will link it here in the right corner and also down below. I don't know if I was saved by God or if it was just a coincidence, if I was just lucky. That will always depend on what you believe or not. But there were so many times in my life when I had a very strong intuition about something. And whenever I would ignore this intuition, things went south. Like literally south. And whenever I would go with the intuition and act upon it, it brought me on the right path, and things really work out great. So the more experience I had with my spirituality, with my intuitions, and also sometimes premonitions, the more I believed in the spiritual world, and I was basically turning my thoughts to the universe. At some point, I was gifted the book The Secret, which I do take with a grain of salt. The whole law of attraction can be a little problematic, but the book back then helped me a lot because I've been someone who always doubted themselves and I had so many negative thoughts, and that book really helped me to turn everything around, and it definitely improved my life. And again, I've been always taking that with a grain of salt, always kind of, questioning things and not being so blindly following everything the book says. And I find that that's very important with anything in life, be it religion or anything else. So anyway, so I started thinking more positively, and I could tell that my life started improving a lot. I started meditating, I started kind of talking to the universe in my head and being grateful for things, and I could tell that everything improved. And it wasn't just a placebo effect where I would say, okay, I could look at things differently. It was very obvious that my life started unfolding in such a great way, and I just can't deny that anymore. And I was still just spiritual, never thought much about God. There were several reasons why I did not identify as a religious person, but rather as a spiritual person. So one thing was the holy books that are out there. Now, they were written by men, and I always questioned whether the men were really honest, because they claimed that God talked to them. And we don't know that for sure, because we have to rely on the word of one person. We don't even know who wrote all these books, you know, and the translation, not always the best. So I did not want to identify myself with a certain religion, because I was questioning the background of basically any religion that is out there. And basically nothing really changed about that for me over the years. Even though now I do believe in God, I feel like I should be able to question things. And the answer, no, you have to believe that because God said so, sounds a lot like you have to do things because I'm your mother and I said so, so that's just not gonna fly with me. I also honestly believe that any type of organized religions that are out there is built around a certain interpretation, and I simply don't believe that I have to belong to a certain group in order to believe in God. I feel like I should be a good person. I should be able to do a random act of kindness, to help people. I should not wish people anything bad. I should be nice, basically a good person. And whenever I'm talking to God, I don't believe I have to use certain words. I can basically form my own sentences when I'm praying, and that should be good enough. I don't really think that I need to belong to a certain group and follow certain, like, a protocol. That's just not what I believe. And that's something that's so deeply rooted in me that I don't think that's gonna change. I mean, I'm open to the concepts of organized religions, and I want to learn more about them, but from what I've seen so far, I don't think that's going to work for me. Also, when you look in our history, there were so many issues with organized religions, so many wars made in the name of God. Religions divided very often people, which is so sad, because at the end of the day, I really believe that no matter what religion you are identifying with, we might share actually the same God. That's just my theory, and it might not be true, but this is what I believe. I think that part of that is because I also believe in science, and I like questioning things, and I like looking at things critically from different points of view. And I honestly believe that one day we might be able to prove that there is God. I think that we just don't have the technology and the knowledge, and it is absolutely possible that we will be able to explain certain things, also spiritual things. So if we live that long, that will be probably very exciting. And now I will tell you how I actually started, or like why I started believing that there is God. So last year was very straining for us all. I mean, the COVID came, we lost Hickey Bear, and it was just a year where I started kind of feeling really down. I think pretty much anyone can identify with that feeling, because these times are very challenging for all of us. And I kind of started losing my hope, my faith in anything. And I was turning inwards, and I was again looking into my spirituality and questioning it. And then one day I've been out in the woods with Shadow, and we went by this church that I very often post photos of on Instagram. That's the church where we go to now regularly. And I decided to take a photo for my sister-in-law, because she loves churches. She's actually very religious. She's Christian, and she loves religious icons. And whenever I see something that I believe she might like, I like taking photos of that and sending them to her so that she knows that I was thinking of her, that I love her. So I thought the light was so beautiful. It was very early in the morning, and it was just so pretty around there. So I asked Shadow to sit in front of the church, and I took a photo. That moment, after I took the photo, a thunder sounded, and it started pouring out of nowhere, because it didn't look like it would be raining at all. But it started pouring, and back then, sadly, I didn't know that the little chapel next to the church was open and that we could have easily hidden there with Shadow, so we went somewhere else. But from that day on, I started feeling this pull towards this church. I felt like I should be there. Something was telling me, go there. You have to be there. So we started taking this route more often, and I started discovering everything around this church. So they have certain displays there, and there's this little chapel. And then at some point I understood that the chapel is open throughout the day and that I can go in even with a dog. I also later learned that the pastor allows dogs at his service. They are allowed to sit in the back seat, like in the back row, which is so wonderful. So one day I took the step and I went inside the little chapel with Shadow. And I can only tell you, it just felt so beautiful and so right being there. I felt this energy going through me, and I felt like all the weight that I felt was lifted from my shoulders. And I started crying. I mean, me crying is nothing new. I'm a Cancer. I do that a lot for basically no reason very often. But it just felt like I came home. And it was such a strong feeling. And at this point, I could not deny it anymore. I just embraced it. And I just started saying a little prayer. I thank God for everything that's in my life, for my wonderful husband, for the food on our table, for the roof over our head, of course, for Mr. Bushytail, and for the time we had with our little hecky bear. And from that day on, I never looked back. I started going to this little chapel. I very often light a candle, and every day I go there to say a little prayer. It's basically me expressing gratitude, sometimes asking for things, but never for myself, because I feel I've been so lucky my entire life, and I'm already so blessed with everything that I just don't feel I need anything else. I feel so content in my life right now, especially since the day when I embraced that I believed in God. It just feels, I don't know, it just feels like I'm finally mentally and physically where I should be. It might sound crazy, but that was basically what led me to believe that all the things that were in my head before about God and spirituality were the right thing. And it's just so beautiful for me. And when I embraced this, I was actually very hesitant to share this with Jack, because I didn't know how he would look at that, because he's an atheist, and I did not know how he would think of me. I was kind of embarrassed, which is ridiculous, because I think you should never be embarrassed. Like, whatever you believe in, these are your beliefs, and people should just respect that instead of make fun of you. But I just felt very embarrassed and hesitant, and at some point I talked about that, and I explained to him why is it so important to me that basically my faith gives me all the strength that I need in order to have some hope and see light in life, and that it just feels so right. Whenever I'm there, it just feels like that's the place where I should be, and it just gives me strength. And honestly, even if that should prove unreal and just in my head works for me, and that's all I need to know. Honestly, I don't know if any of the things that I said made any sense. I hope they did, at least kind of, and I sure hope that I did not hurt or insult anyone. That was definitely not my intention, and if I did, then I apologize. I respect anyone's religion, and I also respect if someone doesn't believe in God at all. As long as you're a good person, as I said at the beginning, you will have a place in my heart. And I think the only thing that's left to say is, what does it mean for this channel now? So you don't have to worry, I'm not gonna force my beliefs on you guys. I don't believe in that. I think that everyone should be free to believe whether they believe in anything at all. And when they believe in something, they should be able to choose what they believe in. So this is not gonna turn into Sunday school here. The only thing I will be saying from now on regularly at the end of each video is God bless you, because that's something that feels very important to me. And it basically only means that I'm sending all the best to you guys, all my love, all the positive vibes. And I just wish only the best things for you. And that's all. You don't have to interpret it the religious way. It's basically like me saying, may the force be with you, you know? So that's the only thing that's gonna change. And I love you all so much. Thank you so much for listening. You can let me know your thoughts on this in the comments, but please be respectful, because it's very personal. And again, I'm not forcing my beliefs on you. It's just me sharing my story. and helping you understand why I feel the way I feel, and that is all. So thank you all so much for watching. God bless you. I love you so, so much, and see you soon. Bye.